Oh man, thank you so much for your patience. I am back. I didn't eat too much today because I was feeling kind of shitty. And then I was like, oh, I'll stream, I'll be fine. And then while I was playing cat games, my appetite came back. So there's a trick for anyone who loses their appetite or anyone who didn't eat a lot that day. Just play some shitty cat games. Apparently it works. I don't know how it did, but it did. So I was leaving Los Feliz by Kevin Parker and Mark Ronson, followed by Salad Days from Mac DeMarco, followed by Elizabeth, My Dear from the Stone Roses, and Nangs by Tame Impala. So those are your four songs. And I'm back. I swear. I'm good. Now we're good. And I guess we'll start with... We could do that. Okay. All right. We can do a little something. You may remember last time I did Spoop Games, I did a really fucking terrible one. Or not last time, but one of the times. And it was just really weird. You were in a house and then a car crashes through the window. Well, I accidentally played a game after that that I thought was by the same developer. But that's in fact not the same developer. That was a mistake. I played After Midnight. The game I was supposed to play was Midnight Library. And I want to thank Reds, who's always looking out for me with horror games. He's my horror game homie. He's been sending me some really shitty horror games, and this is one of them. Enjoy Midnight Library, everyone. Get ready to do a scare to you, and then we'll do something really weird. Okay. The following game is based on a nightmare I used to have. Andrew went to the library to find a book he need for work. He soon found the book he want at the third floor of the library, but then he suddenly fainted. Escape. This is the book I need. Okay, time to go. What? Why am I upside down almost? Did I get... fucking knocked in the head? 12 hours later. Ah, my head. Where am I? I like how the text is stylistic and bold. What? Am I still in the library? Oh, I gotta turn the lights out for this. It's gonna be scary. Oh, warning. You might want to lower your volume a little bit. This dude's games tend to have jump scares, it seems. So there's gonna be some shitty jump scares that are gonna be cheap and possibly loud. So, yeah. Whoa, that was amazing. Thank you for that image. I needed that. That was great. Oh, even on the ceiling, too. It's like Michelangelo. A fucking stretched, pixelated JPEG Michelangelo to rival the Sistine Chapel. Water bottle. Oh, this is my favorite book. Books? You know about books that have covers on all sides? Take a look. Well, and I guess what would you call that part of the book? The spine. Every part of this book is a spine. Spine books. It's new. Oh, it's up. Oh, Stan, it's upside down now. Whoa. Are these types of seating arrangements usually present in libraries? Yes, right? Of course. Uh-oh. Oh. That's, tremendously pale person, somehow managing to be paler than I am. The same books from before, I knew it. This is an evil library, and books are teleporting from one end of the library to the other. It's all a sanity effect. BL books. There's Animu. That's a cool. What kind of library has a book like this, I wonder? Yeah, this is the Yaoi section of the library, huh? That's a good library. Good, yep. Gonna shoot myself in the face in about 5 minutes. Now, this isn't a public library, right? Because I don't think I've ever seen a book section like that in the New York Public Library. Restroom. Hang on, we got another painting. Oh, it's going to be a scare painting. Oh, man. That is definitely scary. I like how they went to Google to type grunge filter. Just, like, put that shit on overlay and then like scratch texture and then put that shit on overlay, and then when this person made this game he went and typed scary image and then just put that shit on overlay. What's this? Manville News. Sewage plant best in Valley. Oh. Hey Jim, just leave this memo to tell you that I left the history room key on the desk with white chairs. You gotta clean the history room tomorrow, Sam. Sam. So this is a restroom. Wow, I thought the restroom was gonna be a bathroom. Nope, it is quite literally a restroom. I mean, there's even beach lounge chairs here in this library. Restroom. Unbelievable. I feel my heart pounding through my chest. My larynx tightening. Words find it difficult to escape. My scare level is 8 out of 10. You will never get out. My scare level is now 9 out of 10. My hands grow increasingly sweatier. My muscles tensing with every movement. My desire for the Yaoi section increases with every step. My boredom grows with every step. So we need to find the table with the white chairs so I can find the history room key. We can go into the history room and learn about some of that cool stuff I've been learning about. Like, did you know that in history there were a lot of wars and that some of those wars never changed? Some of them. Are you aware that at some point in our history there was a year, 1652, that existed? Let's just avoid that section. Let's just like completely avoid that section. Oh, I found the key. This is where the key should be, right? Go and check out the stairs. Well, hang on a minute. Hang on, hold the fort. I'm supposed to be here with the white chairs. No, I'm supposed to check out the stairs. Okay, so I would love to find stairs, but my movement speed, it's almost like I'm stuck in some kind of molasses. Just avoid that section completely. All right, here's the stairs. All right, we're gonna do this through the dungeon doors. Damn it, it's locked. Search the library. Gotta find the key. So, I'm gonna assume that the key is now on the table. Remember, that's not a game design thing. That is the ghosts. This flashlight has an immensely shitty range. I mean, if you had a flashlight like this in real life, you would probably need to replace the batteries, or you'd need to narrow the view a little bit, or I mean, everything in this library is pitch black. There should be some kind of illumination. Come on. I need realistic flashlight physics. Come on, goddammit. Oh, right, the history room. Or the ghosts are blocking the light particles, like Metal has just said. Ah, the history room. See, here's the history people. You may know this famous history person. And is that Nostradamus? That's good. Ah, George Washington. First president of England. And you may have seen this fellow on the Rupel. David Bowie. My favorite historical figure. And Con Ed. The founder of Con Ed. Mm-mm. Sounds like something is opening. A big obvious red button. So, as I leave the history room with the visages of the Beatles on the wall, I feel my foot getting a spooky cramp. Almost as if this cramp wasn't planned. And despite me sitting in the stupidest way possible, there's no way this cramp could be happening right now. A hidden storeroom. Yep, they would have a painting like this in a library, I think. Things to do. Take out the trash, put all the books on the bookshelf, open the stair door. The key is under the Medusa painting. I need you guys to get ready. What the hell is this statue doing here? Clearly murdering people. It's not even a question. The better question is, who bleeds this much and still manages to get away? Hmm. As I walk further through the library, I find my scare level has increased. 9.6 out of 10. The thing about the scare level, it's like warp speed in Star Trek. You can't actually go scare 10. Because scare 10 means you're scared in all the same places, in all of the universe simultaneously. So you can only approach through fractions and decimals to get close to 10, but you can never get scare 10. At scare 10, everything is the scariest thing ever, simultaneously, in all time and space in the universe. Ah, a chat member has just told me I'm on my period. That is a good contribution to the chat, my friend. My scare level after that statement has risen to 9.67. Maybe this is where that person was last seen. Hey, what's this? You will die. You will die. I feel my ass clenching, as if some sort of ghostly force is keeping it tight, like a tiger. What is this feeling? What is this sensation? The walls kind of remind me of a Gucci like bag pattern. Something that is probably the same as a car in most nations. Damn, I think this library is haunted. Oh, come on, have a Pepsi and relax. Just call Pepsi Man. Ah, Father Christmas himself, Santa Claus. Toit. I get toit. Richard's bicycle book. I don't even know where to begin. Oh, this stream brought to you by Pepsi, by the way. Just thought I'd let you know that. Not officially, of course, but in an unofficial capacity, based on that vending machine over there. Did you know that when I played Pepsi Man and I said Pepsi tasted like piss, that someone emailed me and said, "Vinny, how dare you? Pepsi is the most delicious thing ever. I'm unsubscribing." And they did. I mean, unless they lied, but this is the internet. People don't lie on the internet. Shame on you. There's another massive section of the library. I find myself growing increasingly pained in my leg, almost as if it's fallen asleep from not having moved in the past 15 minutes out of sheer boredom. There's a light on in the library over there. Oh no, they locked the stairs. That's a statement you don't hear very often. Locked the stairs. Have the movement speed of a slug. So I don't think I'll be climbing over the fence anytime soon. Parkour also seems sadly out of the question. Superintendent, please open. No. No. Audio visual room. What's this? Oh my God, there's competing vending machines. The stream is no longer brought to you by Pepsi. Okay, a rainbow box of tissues, I guess. I don't understand. Why is this modeled? What's the point of having this? Something is on the wall. 2F computer tables. Okay, so I have to go check that one then. You know, even if I stumbled upon it by accident, something tells me there wouldn't have been anything there until I walked into the bathroom.
Ah! Whoa!
Just a random map in a bathroom stall. So that way when you take a shit, you can examine the computer tables and where they are and the layout.
Ha!
Wish there was a run button. We can get so much of this done so much quicker. Gee, it's a good thing I had that map. All 6 computer tables. I wouldn't want to have to check all of them just in case there's a key on. Oh, look, I found it. Looks like the key to the audio visual room. Oh, shit, eyeballs. My scare level has risen from 9.67 to 9.76. I feel my heart pounding inside my cold, empty chest. I went to the library last week and got locked inside. This is my last message. I hear the piano music now. There is something weird happened in this place. I keep hearing weird sounds and saw some strange people walking. I don't know if I can make it out alive. Those things happen here is freaking me out. I left this key on the table in this room. Turn around.
Whoa.
I like that. That's good. My scare level decreases to 9.3. Because that just looks too jovial to be scary. Don't you just love Spooptober? So much good content. This is where the superintendent lives. You can see the book here. I don't know what's going on there. The pages have some kind of illustration on them. Nice book textures. I wonder what this switch do. What it do? What? Why you do? Floating things. There's some floating stuff on top of that book. Well, how do you activate? Maybe I activated it just by going near it? I guess the stairs are now open, everyone. Do you like how the game said what the fuck for me? Why did Father Christmas turn into that? Come on.
Whoa. Whoa.
I slowly inch my way towards the gated off section of the library to find that the gate entrance is now open. I can go down the stairs. The stairs are open for business. I think I can go out from the main door or underground what? Parking? Underground painting? What have we got here? Is that a Captain America? Oh yeah, look at that. Lil Wayne, Captain America, Bernie Madoff, Monster, Justin Bieber. Is that Anthony Weiner? Carlos Danger himself? Good selection of swill. The best, most quality swill.
You're going to get out of here. You'll die inside here.
Oh! Hmm.
Copy room. We're almost done. I swear we're almost done. Maybe. I don't know. Gotta find the thing here. There's the printer. God. Wow, it almost looked like a piece of paper fell to the ground. That's pretty good. Books borrowed 137, DVD borrowed 26, gallery key at staff only area, main door key Jason has it. Staff Jason Sandy, okay. You see that? Oh my God, Slenderman. Slenderman. Robert R. Slenderman, attorney at law. Here's some more books. I mean, so what the fuck is the name of this section? New books. Oh, okay, I see. So here's some new books. Hedwig and the Angry Inch. Constructing a Good Dissertation. The Walking Dead. I believe that one's probably new. This kid. Richard's Bicycle Book. Something tells me that's not new. I'm pretty sure Snow White isn't new. Maybe they're reprints. Maybe they're reissues. I don't know. It's fine. There's a lot of Walking Dead in this here library. And The Culling, which the hit game was based off of. The hit game known as Fear, and not, in fact, The Culling. Top news, 40 children disappear in the library. Police came but found nothing. Those children have vanished. That's a good news article that, you know, to keep there for your employees and customers to read. Morale will be boosted. People will come back. Library is closing next week. Weird things keep happening there. So much weird things keep happen. There. That's definitely a good reason to close down a business. P for parking, and it's closed. Security room is closed. I have to go to the main room. I think we're almost done. So, I just have to try to stay awake a little bit longer. as I thrust myself further into the library's pussy. I think to myself, man, all of this looks exactly the same. And then I tremble with fear, realizing that I am the pussy. Hey, Coca-Cola, take a look. More Coca-Cola. Even though I don't drink soda. Not anymore, I don't. I think I find myself having a soda like once every 3 or 4 months. I go for seltzer or ginger ale. Because, I think soda is probably the worst thing ever, maybe. I remember one time when I was a young bab, poured a Coke on the grass. I thought they would enjoy it as much as I did. Grass died. And I figured if it's not good enough for grass, then it's not good enough for me. Thousands of grass, all dead within a day. Drink diet. No, man. No, it's the sugar. And even with diet, it's like there's. I'm pretty sure diet is not a whole lot better for you than. Well, I mean, hey, that's your choice. I mean, I'm sure there's plenty of research that you can look up. I don't really know. But I'm good. Is this interstellar concept art? Jesus Christ, I think it is. It's the black hole. There's the thing. I forget the name of it. Diet Coke gives you cancer, people are saying in chat. Oh. Well, I mean, the chat isn't exactly a research organization. However, a lot of people seem to be saying that. And, I don't know. I mean, I just don't know. But I definitely feel like avoiding soda is a good thing for me to do in my life right now. Because it's very sugary and, you know, it also, weighs heavily, and I just feel like you can do a little bit better with bubbles. You can, if you want bubbly things, you can do bubbles with, like, you know, tonic water or seltzer or like ginger ale. And I know ginger ale has sugar in it too, so I don't really even drink that too often. Mostly, like, unsweetened iced tea if I can help it. It's boring, but, you know, it's what it is. It's like this game. Sure, unsweetened iced tea is kind of boring. But in the end, it'll make you hate life. Oh wait, no, that's just this game. Never mind. So how about that? Oh man. Oh. Oh, scary baby face. Oh no. Green tea? Yeah, I like green tea. I'm a fan of green tea. Okay, door to underground parking lot should be unlocked now. Please end this. Please. We're... You know... My car is in parking lot, but I need to open gate first. I will never go to this haunted place again.
Hey, gamers, do you like to get fucked in the throat? If so, check out our new Mountain Dew flavor, cock!
Yo, is this my character's car? Fuck, that car scares the shit out of me. Yeah, the paint job is horrendous. And is it translucent? Yeah, this car is mostly translucent. No wonder it's so scary. It's a ghost car. Who is that person over there? You see person? I don't see person. Oh, it's Slendy.
Oh, Carl. Carl, you an idiot. Play a record.
Scare car. Scare paintings. Alright, my scare levels are approaching maximum now, though, guys. I gotta admit, I'm as close to scare 10 as you can get without actually getting... I'm like scare 9.99999 times infinity. Oh, here's my SUV. We did it. Oh, is this the Jurassic Park car? Uh-oh. Oh, it actually is Slenderman! Holy shit! What the hell? I think I'm having a hallucination. It seems that the thing in front of me is actually a static image. That's my hallucination. To calm down. Nice juice. Slender child. Dead body found inside the library. A dead body found inside the library this morning. Librarian said he found a car with a corpse in the underground parking lot this morning. The police came and investigated the whole library, but found a lot of blood. And weird stuff in the library. Good literary skills. Good reporting skills. They soon contact the FBI, because it looks like something bad happened last night. FBI had blocked the whole library for investigation. Last month, 40 children vanished inside the library, and now a man got killed? Is Midnight Library haunted? YouTuber Gamer said he is not afraid of horror games. A YouTuber named Choppy Pine said he is not afraid of any type of horror games. Yeah. He said that he has balls of steel. Oh shit, it's that painting again. Oh, that was a nipple. Oh, that's weird. What the fuck was that? I didn't want to see that. That last part of the article was almost a commentary about too cool for school YouTubers and people like myself who say they don't scare. Meanwhile, here I am. I shat in my pants, down to my pant leg, like 7 times due to, like, super scares. Shillag in chat just says, Vinny, that was one of the worst games you've ever played. Nah. Come on, you've seen some of the other shit I've played. That was one of the most unsatisfying things I've ever played. Like, I don't feel anything. That's been like the recurring statement lately, huh? A lot of games have been doing that to me. Jesus Christ. All right, we have another one here. This is Breach and Clean. I believe this one was made by Rame Ismail. Whom you may know from Nuclear Throne fame. Oh, that's interesting. Menu. Zen mode start. Let's start. Is that a remix of Final Fantasy VIII's card battle theme? And it kind of isn't. Okay, so what do I have to do here? I have to... Oh, okay. Oh, okay, yeah, that's how you do it. Puke stains.
The girl there is on. Mustn't drag way.
Possibly semantic in nature, I'm not sure. Do you need assistance? You're fired. Job held for 1 hour and 20 minutes. Oh. Oh, I guess I'm not supposed to be in the same room as someone taking a bath, huh? I'll figure this out yet. I didn't even need dynamite for that. The fuck is this plate? Plate is shit. There's like blue fortune cookies on that plate. Oh, that's how you clean. Got it. Alright, no one's taking a shit. No one's taking a piss. Drain the tub. Okay. Flush the toilet, just for fun. Switch the toilet paper rolls. Okay, oh, we got some work to do here. Oh man, I always wanted to clean. This is a dream come true in video game form. What is this? Oh, that's filthy. That is disgusting. That is rancid. That's rank. I guess green towel. There you go. Oven. Doesn't look like anything else needs cleaning here. Ooh, I need to clean. Let me clean. Let me do my job, Clunkus Klein. Clungus Klein, please.
Kai stumbling in the prongler. You crawled, Darison. Stop going.
But wait a minute. Maybe I'm supposed to blow him up with dynamite? Hang on. I'm gonna figure this out. Someone might need to get blown up with dynamite.
Wrong hay.
Okay, here's a person. Here's dynamite.
Peace out. Peace out. One book way.
Oh, it's fish. It's not fortune cookies. It's fish.
Master the Bragway.
Master the Bragway. Fleece out.
Yeah, I know. Fleece out. Fleece out. Scrunglin. Scrunglin.
Master the Bragway.
You fucking disgusting asshole. Eating fish whole. Leaving the head and the fins. Being wasteful. And then just dropping the fish at your feet. That is disgusting.
Fleece out. Wrong hay.
Disgusting like hell.
Master the Bragway.
Oh, Strump lies in grave, clones.
Here, take a towel. Bragway. Oh, they wanted me to clean. There was a sign that said clean. Cleaning is good. Cleaning is fine. This place, they don't want me to clean. This place is locked. So I'm just gonna go ahead and clean anyway. Because it is my job. Take your, like, shit-stained towels. I told you about Shit Rag Alley, right?
Gracing finalists, proactivating Swannel Greymon. Hoi.
Hoi.
Waiting Groudwood Crossing Friend.
Yeah, I Crossing Friend.
You and Comrade Garning.
Oh, Crossing Friend. Yeah, Crossing Friend. Absolutely.
Downring, Quentry Dodging. Whoa, you send it 8 Woosner Drimmin.
I won. Oh, wait, no, maybe I have to change some toilet paper. Yeah, Shit Rag Alley is, I'm gonna flush this person's piss because they were unable to flush their own piss. Shit Rag Alley, there was a little alley in this hotel in Wildwood, New Jersey. And it was, I remember there was just a washcloth with poop on it. And so my cousin and I dubbed it Shit Rag Alley. The, Aqua Beach, I believe, was the name of the hotel. I went into more detail another time. And I'm not going to go into the full detail now, nor do I feel like recounting that entire story. But it is absolutely... It was disgusting. It was gross. And it was poop. It was there for like 3 days, too. That's the best part.
Piss out! Strumpglazing the Sprondler?
What? Sprondler? No Sprondlers. Okay, here we're closing. Okay. Oh, I see. Okay, so that's good. That's good. Alright. So, now what? Are we done? I think I just have to drag this back. I'm not sure. Oh, then you go to the next floor. Oh, I see. So now there's 4 rooms. I understand how this works now. I guess it's a high score game. I think this is probably made for a game jam, no? So you just complete various cleaning tasks. Try not to get caught by the people. Replace their towels. Flush their piss. Attempt to make their bed while they're still sleeping in it.
Fleece out.
There's gotta be a way I can get them out of bed.
Fleece out.
I can't just blow them up. kind of cool, randomly generated rooms and challenges. I quite like this. This is a interesting concept for a game, and I do not think that it is a full game by any means, but it is a cool little game jam type thing. Okay, so this room is clear. This room is still not fully clear.
Wumpa Quay.
Bless the Plunk Quay.
Plungahay.
Plungahay. Wumpa Quay.
No. Okay, I guess I can't do anything here. Okay, I'm gonna do this last floor, and then I'm gonna switch to another game that you guys might enjoy. Sheet towel. Rank ass fucking towels. Ass towels. I never envy the people that have to clean up hotel rooms. Especially the really filthy ones, like where people go to just, like, have consensual adult relations in exchange for currency. Those hotel rooms in particular, those have got to be a fucking nightmare to clean. Because you got to be like... It's like Gordon Ramsay when he was semen hunting, you know? It's like that. Oh god, it's like a mosaic of semen. And that's your job, is to clean that constantly. Unless you don't, in which case you just end up in a shitty hotel that has, like, blood on the bed. Blood bed bagel.
You grow very soon. Can I still be in the prongler? The monk is crying.
I think you have to just be super quick when there's someone in there. Oh shit. Oh, we're not closing. I'm not done. It's this room. It's this fucking room. I'm not sure what else to clean. What? So there's dynamite in the bathtub. What else is there to do? I can't make your beds. Alright, well, you prolapse on your own, my friends. No, you don't need toilet paper. Turns out you can make beds while they're on it. It just wasn't happening. Rooms cleaned 5, floors cleaned 1. Job held for 8 hours and 28 minutes. Well, it's the longest. It's the longest I've ever held a job for in my life. Actually, that distinction goes to 5 years at a job, actually. I put my 5 years in. And I got treated like a dirty red bastard with no respect. Huh? That was a cool game. Yep. I'm okay. Give me a minute. You just heard the sound of water going down the wrong pipe. I'd like to blame Dirk Trash in the chat. Now I sound like Bobcat Goldthwait. I'll be right back, homie. And that's why I'm not able to hold a fictional job for more than 8 hours, because I keep forgetting how to swallow water properly. Okay. I'm okay. I'm in tip-top No, I'm good. I'm in tip-top shape, I swear to God. Alright. This is a game called North. Okay. Two qualities, good and low. Whoa. Synthesizer hits me. This is a game that's been recommended by at least 3 or 4 people. Megabytes. Wow. That is interesting. The title is North. A Netflix original series. Dear sister, yesterday I arrived in the city. I know I promised to write sooner. I wanted to. I tried. Well, I wanted to, T-O it should be. But it's, you know, it's the narrator is probably not very good. These things, but the desert is unforgiving and restless, and I didn't have a moment to breathe. You can't even begin to imagine what it's like. The burning heat, landscapes of fire. I applied for asylum today. The people here speak strangely, so I don't really understand what I have to do. I'm sure I'll figure it out quickly, though. In the meantime, I will try to write everything down so I don't forget how things work around here. Don't be mad at me. I will write more often from now on. If everything goes according to plan, I'll be able to send you money soon. Maybe you can join me. The South is not a good place for people like us anymore. I hope you're well. Kiss Eric for me. Love, your brother. What are these frame rates? I mean, it's kind of probably intentional, because it is... This is a Unity game. Whoa, voice, please. I just had a coughing fit for anyone who missed it. But, yeah, it's a full cinematic. 20 frames a second, I guess. This is my home. This is not my beautiful house. This is not my beautiful E.T. This is not my beautiful burn victim! Do you feel bad? You will. You can take pills in this game. All right. All right. All right.
all. Right. Cool radio station. That's where they play all the top 40 white, not white noise sine waves. So we're not gonna fix that then. Oh my sweet fucking god. What the fuck are you? And what are you? This is my kind of weird. What chromatic aberration is happening? I don't know if it's because of the pills that my character just took. It reminds me a little bit of Crypt Worlds mixed with a Burn Band game. I don't think there's a way I can turn up the brightness on this because the escape button in Unity games just usually exits them, and I don't want to take that risk. Welcome to work. Yep, this is the old factory. It's where I make my paltry wage so that I can afford more aliens for my house. Have nothing to offer. I'm supposed to feed Satan. Okay. Yep, I'll do that. This is a cool job. Lots of nice things you can do here at the job. Did you see the frightened ones? Did you hear the falling bombs? Did you ever wonder why we had to run for shelter when the promise of a brave new world unfurled beneath every poo-poo? Whoa! So, these are the mines? Oh, I have to activate before I die. Oh, I see. Okay. Death is imminent. Don't know if I did it. I don't know if I did my job. How many of these fucking things are there? Oh, there's that one. I did that one already. It's another day at the factory, and I, Gregorio Ilivinovich, have found my work to be rewarding over the years. Immensely so. There's one for every canister. Okay. So, I'm still missing... a number of them. Can I feed the Scrogon?
So there's a moth that walks into a podiatrist's office. I'm not gonna go ahead and tell the rest of the joke. I can't even say the word podiatrist correctly, so I'm not gonna go ahead and ruin Norm's joke. By the way, Norm MacDonald's book is really good. I know I said this the other day, but I'm still working on it, and it is fantastic and surreal and weird and amazing and really funny. It's not gonna win over new fans, but he's definitely done a good job at writing a book in Norm style. Here we go, I'm gonna die now. Ooh. Oh, that was a good save. I think I might have... Right click just makes me go really fast. Yeah. Jeff, you said you know what's going on here. What am I supposed to do? Every time I activate a generator, it produces a rock on the other side. Oh. That one. This kind of blows. I know there's one more somewhere. Okay, got that one 1,000 times. Here's the last one. You're a good worker. Positive reinforcement leads to happy workers. Blade Runner 2 has an official title now. It's called Blade Runner 2049. There's a picture of Ryan Gosling and Harrison Ford, Ridley Scott, and Denis Villeneuve. Is how you say his name? He was an excellent director. I'm glad Ridley's on the project. And Hampton Fancher wrote the script. I did it. Yeah, work is done. I think. Hampton Fancher wrote the original script, so I think it could be good. I'm a little worried, because I love Blade Runner so much. I'm not sure a sequel's gonna do well. Not sure it could really top the first one, but I'm still interested. And Harrison Ford said it was the best script he ever read. Now I know what you're thinking. This is the same guy that said But I mean, why would he say it's the best script? What does he have to gain from that, aside from a shitload of money? One of my roommates bought some drugs. She told me that the pills would help her control her dreams. Become lucid, she said. She wanted to manipulate the doctors so they believe her story. At least that was the plan. I'm sitting so far away from my screen, I can't read some of these letters. She's sick now, dying maybe. I don't think I've seen her awake in days. On the radio, they tell stories of the South sometimes, but the protests, the hunger, the diseases. Even for someone that had to flee from the place, it seems so much worse than it really is, like we are animals. Like we come from hell. I miss it sometimes. My hell. You, Eric. I miss my freedom, too. Everything here is monitored. My thoughts do not feel like my own anymore. And if there was a voice in my head ordering me what to do... As if, rather. I haven't heard from you since I left. I miss you. My flat is a mess. It's dirty and humid and I barely sleep at night. One of my roommates is going completely nuts, constantly mumbling things about the eye controlling his thoughts or whatever. My other roommate just spends his days staring at weird pictures he found in the desert. Says they are memories of all those who died on the way. I don't know. He thinks we're all trapped. They need us here, he said, but they have no use for free men. I work at a factory that seems to provide energy for the lower parts of the city. It's a loud place that smells like sulfur and rot. There's a creature in a tank filled with some kind of acid. The poor thing is obviously in horrible pain, but I'm neither allowed to touch it nor speak to it. They call it the Mother. I don't know why. My roommate says we'll end up in one of those graves painted along the factory. Planted along the factory, rather. I hope he's wrong. In order to run faster in the mines, I have to drink some kind of bitter liquid they call speeder. And every time I concentrate, I'm able to run. I mean run, like really, really fast. It hurts my head, burns every muscle. It's like I'm going to explode. My flatmate is right. These people don't care about us. We're just tools to them. The soulless workforce. The mines are burning hot. It's impossible to stay in there for more than a few seconds, and I constantly have to go back to the healing bay, which is at the entrance of the mines. My job is absurd. Basically, I have to activate 3 big jackhammers, collect the extracted stones. I was supposed to read this before I did that, huh? I have no idea what these stones are. I think there's some type of food for the creature in the tank. They look like eggs. Love your brother. Future elevator music. Yeah, this definitely reminds me of some other strange things I've played in the past, most specifically Burn Band. City is so empty. I mean, you can see buildings, hear cars, and obviously millions of people live here, but you almost never see anyone on the streets. I never saw a child. A single one. Can you imagine that? It's like everyone's either old or dead. Love, your brother. There's something about a shitty resolution and limitations that lets your imagination fill in the rest of the blanks. The immigration office, huh? What? No, fuck. What? It's okay. Oh, hey, GPM. GPM, you never made it this far. I don't even know what's going on. Like when I met Tommy Wiseau yesterday, he said, "I don't even know what's happening, man." I was like, "Yeah, dude, me too." And I just went the opposite way. So, wait a minute. I entered the immigration office and nothing happened. Maybe I backed out of it. You have to convert first? What? To what? Okay. All right, fair enough. There's a church you're supposed to go to above your apartment. Okay. The city's watching me. Chat is telling me to become either a Zoroastrian or a Scientologist. Good dialogue. Holy fuck, do you see that guy? That's awesome. What is this? Oh, it's like a Balchinian. I guess this is the processing plant. Where they process their food into crimes. What the fuck? Okay. They're gone now. They're gone. They're gone. They've teleported to those coordinates. Whoops, I thought all I had to do there was interact with them and teleport them to some other place, but it turns out I actually have to use the machine. Pass the test. I mean, yeah, oh, okay. There's a heart. I don't know what we're about to see here, but just, if you're squeamish, I don't know, maybe, there could be some shit that's crazy. I don't know. Oh, I don't like that. I know what that is. Let's look over here instead. I am so confused, as I usually am. I don't know if I'm supposed- what am I supposed to recognize here? I have X-ray hand, yep. Child playing ball, playing catch. think that's all of them. Oh wait, one more. You're guilty. Mm-hmm. Objection! So, I guess I can explain that dog head thing. It's actually, it's rumored to be completely fake. And it likely is, but it's old footage of a dog's head being kept alive, independent of the dog's body. That's why when I saw it, I was like, oh, right, that's a little extreme. But it is most likely bullshit. Like, very, very, very likely bullshit. And especially for when it was supposed to be filmed, which is like, you know, 40s, 50s. It's like, yeah, I don't think we had the technology to do that. People are saying it's likely propaganda. Oh my god, this is so fucking weird! Take the pill or exit. Okay, visual epilepsy warning. You might want to look away now. Listen, I have people arguing the validity of the dog head situation. Which, I mean, I don't know. I'm just telling you, I have no idea what it is, but it's likely. It's likely not real. So yeah, this is what happens when you take drugs. This is where the machine elves make themselves known. The spirit molecule works. That is such amazing and creepy imagery, I love it. In the corridor from the police station, there's this poor old guy who comes every day. I don't know what he does there. He seems sad. Today he told me that all the people on the screens are terrorists except the kids. He says I should recognize only the kids. I asked him who the kids are, but he just said, when the world was young and we were all dying of thirst, what did I do? I hid. Like we all hide when darkness is at our doorstep. The officer at the police station is an enormously fat woman who speaks with a weird accent. She doesn't like me. She says people like us can't be trusted. Only natives seem to think that everyone from the south is a terrorist. But I saw what they do in the desert. Who are they to judge? Anyway, I think I spent too many hours waiting in lines and filling out forms. Believe it or not, some days I miss the desert. To prove that I'm not a terrorist, I have to watch the videos of people. They all look unreal, slightly faded away, like dreams from the past. The police want me to say which person I recognize, but I've never seen any of them. Who are they? Are they dead? Looks like they've been experimented on. Like someone did horrible things to them. Sometimes I fear I'm looking at ghosts. But I'll end up on the screen sometime too. I told the doctors why I had to leave the South. The insults, the beatings, the threats. I told them everything. I'm not sure, but I think they're supposed to determine if my story is real. They give me pills that make me fall asleep. I don't know what happens then. I think they watch my dreams. That music is cool. So I guess we recognize only the kids. Yeah, this definitely fills the weird moniker. I just love the creativity of people just not having to make a coherent narrative or a clear narrative. I like people just fucking like that make shit like this. Basically, pure creativity. Even with the limitations of the designing of the game, I definitely like seeing people make something that is truly unique and interesting and strange and something right out of their imagination. That's why Crypt Worlds was such a big favorite for me. Still haven't found very many things that I like as much as Crypt Worlds, however. Chillin's only. Do wrong. Those were all chillins. You fucked up on the leapfrog one. I fucked one up. Wait, was the leapfrog not chillins? Leapfrog is, I guess they're, they're adults, you're right. Yeah. Or, at the very least, young adults, I guess, I don't know. But yeah, that was the one. Not that I have any idea why I needed to pass that test, but I did it. Okay, so maybe I'll head back to my apartment. No pills. I'm not taking those pills. I need to convert. You're right. I need to go to church. I need to go to Astro Church. Mega Church. I need the church to take me higher. Time to Wololo. Good reference, bro. Your references are out of control. Oh, yes, this is my kind of church. The Church of the Eye. I'll just leave this up for a second or two so anyone new that's just joining can join to this. And then shake their heads and leave. Welcome to Vine Sauce. If only it were that easy. You have not been seen? So does that mean I didn't convert? Closer to the eye, maybe. Security cams. Well, I know I was seen by a security camera earlier. It's too fucking dark to see anything else down here. So, I mean, maybe that. Let's see, I'm being seen. Church of the Mega Thrust Fuckass will now accept me. Oh, so you're saying I need to be tripping and I need to be seen? Alright. The best way to convert while on drugs. I've only come across these three cameras so far. Maybe there's some on the second floor that I missed. Go to the doctors on drugs. So far, we have three cameras that have seen me. Make that four. It looks like there are only those four. I don't know if I'm actually... Don't think I need to go to the doctor. The There's one on the roof. If I missed something obvious, you'll have to forgive me. Because I'm, oh yeah, I thought that was just... I did it. Okay, now I can convert, probably. I'm also, like I said, having, a bit of a recovery from a fucking long-ass weekend of walking around in New York City and Comic-Con and meeting people. I'm on a come-down right now. Play Babysitter Bloodbath next. Nope! I finished it. Oh yes, we're all one with the eye now. Praise the eye, everyone. Praise it with me. Look into the eyeball. There actually is no second Babysitter Bloodbath. There's an unofficial, like, not unofficial, there's like a spiritual sequel, like Drillhead Man or something. And I think there was some work being done on a sequel, but it was never finished. So that probably won't be a thing for a while. That developer made more games that are equally as shitty. I'm breaking, I'm shaking, I'm breaking like humans do. I know where I have to go next. Oh. Oh, this is a first. Hello. I got into the elevator with some huts. Except I have not learned huttese yet. Power Drill Massacre is 5 times more impossible than the Babysitter game. Oh, yep, that sounds great. I nearly had some kind of fucking double aneurysm conniption fit while playing Babysitter Bloodbath. Could you imagine a game that's 5 times harder than that? Yeah, that's 5 hours of salt. Immigration office. It's watery. Shadow Link is out there somewhere. If Vinesauce ever gets some kind of an office building, it's going to be modeled after this. That visual burn into your retina for a little bit. Door is closed. No? It is on YouTube, The Babysitter Bloodbath Part 2. Part 1 is in another collection. It's in the comments on the Babysitter Bloodbath video. But yeah, it's all up. It's all on YouTube. I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to do here. Maybe something to do with the doctor? So I have to get documents from the doctor's office before I can do this. So, the question is, how do I get documents from the doctor? Do I just have to trip balls again? Take the pills, then go to the doctor's. So, oh, there's an order. So I need to get fucked off my ass on prescription meds and then have the doctors administer a lethal dose of DMT. I gotcha. Vin, why can't you read letters? Because there's no read letter button. You have to go to one of these to read the letter. I think I finally understood what the immigration officers want from me. Honestly, I have to get 3 documents. Or basically, rather. In room 1, they need to certificate that confirms I gotta sit up to read this because, again, I can't read it when I lay back. Certificate that confirms I'm able to work. In room 2, they want proof I was persecuted in the South. In room 3, I have to provide a testimony from the police that says I'm not a terrorist. I know. Easier said than done. I know that I should be thrilled to be here, to have made it. I'm not. My body still feels like it's covered by the whole desert. My mind feels just numbed. This place is not how I dreamt it would be, or how we pictured it. Remember when we used to spend entire nights imagining our lives in the big city? Remember all the crazy places we thought we would see? People we would meet? The lovers we would have? It's not like that. The immigration office is a strange place. There's a dead tree that smells like gasoline, and the ground is covered with something that looks like water but isn't. The whole building is more like a ruin than anything else. The natives call it the temple. Nobody there speaks to me. Nobody even acknowledges my presence. Am I really here? Sometimes I feel like I never made it out of the desert. Is this what purgatory looks like? People call it the temple, after all. Okay, now I can sit back again. So, we take pills, we go to doctor. It's all an allegory. Speaking of allegory, could you imagine writing a book that's taught in schools hundreds of years after you finish writing that book and die? Could you imagine? You know what you gotta do? You gotta write some real fucking good allegory if you wanna do that. Thank you. Oh, this is different. Yeah, this is different. But only slightly. Just the colors are a little different. But it's flashing again, so... Yeah, epilepsy warning. That was double drugs. What the fuck? It's the woman's bathroom. Love. Okay, I think, well, the document has been acquired, so now we're real close now. Also, just for anyone who's been curious, a lot of people have been emailing me telling me to play Albino Lullaby Episode 2. It's not out yet. I double-checked. On Steam, it says Episode 2 will be out September 2017. So that'll be a next year Halloween thing. You didn't get the documents? Okay. That's cool. I got a letter. I need to retake the drugs. Fucking Christ. So wait. Do I have to talk to the doctor again to get my goddamn documents? Doctors that I'm gay. What? I think that's what they're looking for. Proof that I had to flee because of my sexual orientation. How do you prove that you're gay? I get it. How do you prove that people want to kill you? I mean, it's not like they give you a certificate before hunting you down. Do you think Eric could help? Where is he? Is he coming soon? My roommate says I can control my dreams if I take her pills. I don't know. I totally understand what I have to do now. This is such a fucking weird game. Holy shit. So yeah, I have to go back into the dream, and instead of making out with a woman's bathroom, I have to make out with a men's toilet. You okay? You doing all right? Fucking weird game. Oh, hey, friend. Ding. Let's do this again. Okay, epilepsy warning again. All right, so I know what to do. Now we just have to find the blue person. I see. Oh, I can't jump. I can't jump down, or I can't fall down. I have to go down a ramp. All right. Oh, I've been meaning to tell you guys, I have an early copy of Shadow Warrior 2. Not that that means anything to most of you, but Shadow Warrior was a great game, and Shadow Warrior 2 is out really soon, and I got a chance to play a little bit of it today, and I'll be streaming a little bit of it soon, and it's really good. So far, it's got a lot of things from Shadow Warrior 1 that I loved, but there's like fucking 70 weapons and there's randomly generated stuff and tons of enemies and light RPG elements. Yep, that's a definite epilepsy warning right there. Finally, I have my papers. And it's got 4-player co-op. It kind of almost strikes me, and I don't know how true this is because I didn't get that far in it yet, but it almost strikes me a little bit like a Diablo kind of, like there's a Diablo feel to it. You and three of your friends, like, go through the randomly generated missions and earn weapons that are, like, stronger. Like, when you go into the pause menu, you see stats for the weapons. And you can customize them, you can put idols in them to make them do more damage or fire rate. I've seen enemies that are immune to ice, so I'm assuming there's going to be ice attacks. So yeah, it's cool. I was told the game is under embargo. And I can't actually stream it in full, but I can stream a little bit of it. They said I can stream the first few levels and not give a full review until it's out. But I don't really do reviews like that anyway, so I'll probably just show you guys a few levels, and then when it's out, I'll play a little bit more. But I can see myself playing this on my free time because it looks and plays really, really nicely. So thank you, Devolver Digital. You guys do good publish game. Make good publish games. Things accomplished. Oh yeah, Borderlands definitely seems... I mean, who knows, this game could be boring as shit if I play it long enough. You know, it could be one of those things that loses its luster very quickly. Borderlands... Borderlands? No, Borderlands is a cool game for a little bit. I get bored of them very quickly. I remember the pre-sequel, Borderlands the pre-sequel came out, and I was just like, wow, I don't care. So, who knows? And Destiny, I had no interest in. Is Shadow Warrior different? I'm not sure. But I really did like Borderlands the first time I played through it. I liked the guns. I liked the way you could, team up with people and just, like, go on, like, adventures and find cool guns and weird shit. And sure, there were a lot of memes, but sometimes the game had some decent writing that made me laugh. And then it just, like, the law of diminishing returns, where it just got... Oh, wait, there was a locked door. Hang on. I missed the door. Yeah, the door number 4. Sometimes the game would make me laugh, and then the more I played it, and then the more I played, then I played number 2, and then I played the pre-sequel, and by the pre-sequel, I was just not laughing. Well, I was wondering, I forgot about door number four. I forgot that it was locked. I guess I didn't put two and two together to make four. I thought maybe something else opened up somewhere along, you know, the way. Or maybe I had to go back to my apartment, talk to one of those dudes. I don't know. Here it is. Remember I was talking about Borderlands not getting any laughs from me? And then I'm like, 2 and 2 equals 4! And you guys are just like, oh. Anyway. Okay. What? What are these? Are these mailboxes? Congratulations, you made it. You won Asylum. From now on, you will work for us. We do need you, good workers like you. Are you happy? You should be. Now everyone is accepted. Not everyone is accepted in this great city. Oh, by the way, we had to seize your letters. Are you happy? This music is telling me not to be happy. But yes, I am very happy. It was a matter of security. We needed to know what you were doing. They were very sweet, though. Don't worry, we wrote to your sister. We let her know that you're all right. I'm sure you'll be reunited soon. You're a free man now. It's a cool synthesizer sound there. Cool getting laughed at by a video game. And more specifically, a mailbox. And that's it. That's all the mailboxes. Finally have been accepted. Been granted asylum. In the north. I know what this game is doing. I know, I understand it. I think. Maybe. Alright, I don't get any of it. But I think I do. Dear sister, I arrived in the city a month ago. I know I promised to write sooner. I wanted to. I tried, but I had so much to do here, so much to learn. Very nice place, but it's hard to get used to it at first. Anyway, I finally got asylum. I also have a job and a little flat. Things are starting to look up. What about you and Eric? You should join me. Any people here? You would find work easily, and everything is so much better than in the south. I know what they say about the city and crossing the desert. It's true, the desert is hard, but then everything gets better. Believe me, everything is fine once you've left those terrible landscapes of fire behind. It's the allegory. I get what's going on here. I didn't expect allegory from this, or some kind of commentary. It was weird. Please explain. Immigration. The acceptance of certain social behaviors in the South versus the North, you know, being absorbed into some kind of, like, system, some scary, foreign, weird, mechanized culture and system. I don't know, am I close? Does it sound like I'm close? figure it out for yourself, I guess, but that's my interpretation of it. Oh, and aliens and drugs. Don't fuck with aliens. That's what I'm being communicated. And brainwashing, and it's there's a bunch of stuff going on, but it was cool. I like to play weird games that have absolutely no meaning, or so it seems like they have absolutely no meaning, and every now and then you play one that has a little bit of a message, and it's like, oh, it's if it's done right, it doesn't feel heavy-handed. And I think this straddles the line between, you know, slightly obvious and maybe, for me, this is my opinion, I thought it was cool. I thought the visuals were cool. The sounds were great. Some particularly bizarre moments, and the story was kind of interesting. Yeah, and then it felt a little bit on the nose at times, but yeah, it was all right. I liked it. I thought it was okay. I'll leave that up to you, what you feel about it. If you feel it was heavy-handed or not, if you liked it or not, let me know in the comments and description. Or just the Twitch chat just now. You could do that too.